Hello guys, today Apple released the iOS 14.4 update to the public and this had come with a size of over 360 MB for the iPhone level, and this might vary based on the device you are using. And this update will be available from the iPhone 6s users to the iPhone 12 Pro Max user. Along with the iOS 14.4, Apple also released the iPadOS 14.4, and the iPadOS 14.4 came with a size of over 310 MB for this iPad Air 4, and this also might vary based on the iPad you are using. Now let's see what are the new changes and the bug fixes for iOS 14.4. Now if you have not got the update yet, then just go to your setting, then go to general, then tap on software update, and you will be able to see the iOS 14.4 update there. If still you are not able to see the update, then just tap on the automatic update, then just turn it off the download iOS update, then turn it on back. After that it will check for the update, and if there is a new update it will show up there to download and install. Now let's have a look at the build number. Now let's go to setting, then go to about, and here is the build number. As you can see, the build number is 18D52, so that is the build number for the iOS 14.4 update. Now apart from the build number, Apple has also updated the modem firmware. The modem firmware update is not for all the model. They have updated the modem firmware for some of the newer models, and you might not see the modem firmware update for some of the older models. Now the first new feature Apple has given in this iOS 14.4 is the small QR code scanning option in the camera app itself. Now if I am taking one QR code and opening the camera, now as you can see it is giving me a dialog, open the apple.com in Safari. So this kind of small QR codes also you will be able to scan from the camera app directly. So that is the first new feature Apple has given in this iOS 14.4 update. After that, if you go to your setting, then if you go to your sound and haptics, you will find a new option for the headphone safety.
So this feature is helpful for those who listen to music at a very high volume. To prevent any damage to your ear, the system increases or decreases the volume level when it identifies that the sound could do any damage to your ear. In this update, Apple has also added a new option under the Bluetooth. There you can specify the device type for your Bluetooth device. Just tap on the I button for any paired Bluetooth device. There you will see the option. There are many options under the device type. And if the device type is headphone, then the headphone safety features kicks in and try to adjust the volume to prevent your ears from any damage. And when the Bluetooth device type is car stereo or speakers or hearing aid, then iOS will not adjust the volume level automatically. After that, Apple has also included a notification for the iPhone 12 series. In this, the system will notify if the camera is not genuine. For example, you gave your iPhone 12 series for camera repair, and the service center person replaced the camera with a duplicate camera module. In that case, the system will show you the camera module is not original. In that way, you will be sure of your repair. Now, apart from that, in iOS 14.4, Apple has given the support for Hey Siri for the AirPods Max. I don't have the AirPod Max. If you have the AirPod Max, then you will be able to use Hey Siri in that, and it will be able to answer your queries there. Now apart from that, in the iOS 14.4 they have pushed the anti-tracking feature, and the anti-tracking feature is enabled in this iOS 14.4. This will be helpful to stop apps like Facebook and Insta from tracking you from other websites and app for better privacy. You will get a dialog there, and there you can choose whether to allow, or you can ask the app to stop tracking you.
So these are the new features. And if we talk about the bug fixes, now let's see, I will just tell you what are the bug fixes happened for the iOS 14.4. Now the first bug fix they did with the iPhone 12 Pro camera, where the HDR images artifacts were not proper, and that thing they have fixed. When you are taking a HDR photo, that time the metadata, the image details, whatever were coming were not proper, and that has been fixed in this iOS 14.4 update. Apart from that, if you are using the Fitness Plus, right now it is anyway not available in India. So whenever you will use, they have fixed the fitness widget where it was not showing the proper data and it was taking time to update the activity data. That has been fixed in this iOS 14.4. Now apart from that, they have also fixed the keyboard lag issue in the system. So whenever you are typing, so the keyboard lag has been fixed in this update, and when you are typing anything, the keyboard does not give you a lag, and the typing experience is smooth. If you see, there is no lag while typing, whether you type or you use the swipe keyboard, you will not notice any lag. So that is another thing is fixed. And now if you see, the suggestions are also proper, and in the messages app the suggestions are populating properly. After that, Apple also fixed the issue with the multilingual keyboard. For some users, the specific language keyboard was not updating properly and the suggestions were not proper. So that issue has been fixed in this iOS 14.4 update. After that, in iOS 14.4, they have fixed some of the issues with the switch control in iPhones. If you go to your setting, then accessibility, you will see the switch control option there. When this option was on, for some users, they were not able to answer any phone call. Now this issue has been fixed by Apple in iOS 14.4. So those are some bug fixes happened in this iOS 14.4 update. Now in the iPadOS 14.4, also they have fixed the keyboard issue and the language issue. Apart from that, in the iPadOS 14.4, there is no new features. Now I have updated that iOS 14.4 at night around 12 a.m. and it is, as you can see, it is 12 p.m. now. And overall the performance is smooth and fast. The app opening and loading are fast. If you can see, the camera also takes photo smooth and the shutter speed is fine. Now the battery backup also looks fine, because I did not use for much time. I cannot give you an exact review on the battery, but overall I am happy with the battery backup. And if you see, yesterday I almost used 5 hours, and today if you see, I have already used almost 2 hours and it consumed only 25%. So if you calculate, we are getting same 8 to 9 hours of screen on time on a single charge, and this will definitely help you to get a full day of battery life. So overall the iOS 14.4 is a very good update, and at in this point if you ask, then definitely you should update to iOS 14.4 for better stability and security. So that's it guys regarding the iOS 14.4 and the iPadOS 14.4 update. Hope this video is helpful for you. If you enjoyed, then like this video and subscribe to the channel if you have not subscribed already, and support this small channel to grow. I will make a review video on this iOS 14.4 to know more about the battery life, performance, everything. Stay tuned and subscribe to the channel. As always, thanks for watching. Have a great day.